أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي رب زدني علما رب زدني علما رب زدني علما آمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سورة البقرة آيات 67 Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is narrating an incident which occurred among Bani Israel. And due to this incident, this surah has got the name of Baqara, because this incident is relevant to a cow, Baqara. In English, cow is called Baqara. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the incident to Bani Israel. Wa is qala, and remember the incident when asked Musa alayhi salam, when Musa asked to his people, liqawmihi, to his nation, to his people, inna allaha, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you, Ya'murukum an tadhbahu baqara. Allah commands you to sacrifice a cow. A simple order. Slaughter a cow in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sacrifice a cow. Which cow? Any cow. Nothing special. But people of Bani Israel asked, Kalu, they said to Musa, Atattakhizuna huzuwa? Do you ridicule us? You are making fun of us. You are having fun with us. Qala, Musa answered, A'udhu billahi an akuna min al-jahilin. I seek the Allah's refuge from being one of the ignorant.
Okay.
Now, think about the incident. It was a simple order. Musa alayhi salam told his nation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to slaughter a cow in my name. Sacrifice a cow. They should get a cow and slaughter it. But they didn't do this. They asked Musa, you are having fun with us. Why are you saying that we should sacrifice a cow? Musa alayhi salam replied, I seek refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being one of the ignorant persons. What is ignorance? Is having fun with someone, is some ignorant action? No. Actually, ignorance means to have fun with people in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, Musa alayhi salam asked them to slaughter a cow because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them. So, if Musa alayhi salam was having fun with them, it means he is lying upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ma'azallah. Therefore, he said, oh no, I am not an ignorant person, that I will lie upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just to amuse myself. How could I do this? No, I am saying a truth. I am telling you a truth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to sacrifice a cow. Kalu, they replied, Udu'u lana rabbik. O Musa, pray from your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, request to your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yubayyin lana ma hiya, to give us some details of that cow. Question is very strange actually. When you want to sacrifice a cow, what type of cow you will look for? A normal cow? Healthy? And of proper age? What else you will try to find out in a cow? But they asked, request Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide us proper information. What type of cow should we sacrifice? Actually, this was an excuse. But Musa alayhi salam prayed and Allah replied. So, qala innahu yaqulu. Musa replied them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, innaha bakaratul la faridun wala bikr. The cow should neither be too old nor too young, but of middle age. Amanum bayna zalik, but of middle age. Faf'alu ma tu'marun. So now, do what you are commanded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exactly gave the instructions which we already have about sacrificing cows. When we have to sacrifice on Eid, we usually find a cow of middle age. It should not be too old and it should not be too young. So normally we try to find a cow of middle age, 5-6 years old cow. Normally. So Musa alayhi salam had told them the normal criteria that as in routine, you try to find a middle-aged cow for sacrifice. Same order is now. Try to find out a middle-aged cow, and obviously they have many of them. So take one of them and slaughter it in the name of Allah to perform the sacrifice. But they didn't stop. قَالُدْ أُولَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّلْ لَنَا مَا لَوْنُهَا. They said to Musa that, O Musa, please request your Rabb, request your Allah to clarify for us her color. First thing, did you notice that they never said, O Musa, Kalud ulana rabbana. O Musa, request our Allah. No, they said, Musa, request your Allah. So from the depth of their hearts, they didn't accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as their Lord. And through this incident, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing the same thing. Musa alayhi salam gave them the order to slaughter a cow. It's not a big deal. It wasn't a great thing to do. They have many cows. And one cow, any one cow, could be slaughtered and they can fulfill the Allah's order. But they were not ready to fulfill Allah's order. So they were making excuses out of nonsense. So what are they asking? What should be the color of the cow? What does that mean? What is the criteria of color about cows? This is a clear nonsense. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. So, Musa alayhi salam prayed and Allah replied. So, qala innahu yakulu innaha baqaratun safra ufaqi'un lawnuha tasurrun nazirin. Musa alayhi salam got his answer and now told his people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that Cow should be a rich and deep yellow color, pleasing to the eyes. Yellow means the goldish brown color. Actually, safra means yellow and faqe means black, dark brown. So, yellow and dark, pitch dark brown will mix, and when you will mix them, you will get the brown color, which is a normal color among the cows. You have seen many cows of brown color, and most of the cows have this color. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered them that cow should be of a rich, deep brown color and tasurrun nazirin, pleasing to the eyes. When someone will look at it, he will feel pleasant. It should be beautiful. Qalud ulana, they asked Musa, ud ulana rabbaka, request your Rabb, yubayyin lana mahi, clarify for us the exact type of cow she should be. Innal baqara tashabaha alayna, for to us all cows look alike. Now check their behavior. If you have many cows of this kind, who has middle age and who has beautiful dark brown color and who are beautiful, and to watch them is a pleasant experience, then take one cow out of them and slaughter it. Why are you making questions and making excuses? But they don't want to do this. Still, they were in love of cow. Remember, before some time, they already made a calf and started worshipping it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them. After a while, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them through this incident and showed their munafiqat, their hypocrisy on Musa alayhi salam. So they don't want to slaughter a cow actually. Therefore, they were making excuses. So now they said, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is your Lord Musa, who is your Rabb Musa, that he clarify for us the exact type of cow she should be. Because all cows are look alike for us. وَإِنَّا إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ لَمُهْتَدُونَ, if Allah wills, we shall be rightly guided. This is the major excuse of every person who is not ready to obey Allah's order. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, then I will be guided. So they made the same excuse. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like to guide us, we will be rightly guided. قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ, Musa alayhi salam prayed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and got his answer. And now he addressed his nation again and told them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إِنَّهَا بَكَرَةُ لَا زَلُولٌ تُسِيرُ الْأَرْضُ وَلَا تَسْقِي الْحَرْثَ, this cow should have neither been used to till the soil nor water the fields. Musallamatul lashiyata fiha, a healthy one, free from any blemish. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restricted them. Allah said, find out a cow which had never done some work. She never watered the fields. It never plowed the soil. and it has no blemish in it. Fully healthy and strong. Now find it out. It was a difficult task now, because every person who has a healthy cow in his possession, he must use it in his fields, to plow his fields, to water his fields, obviously. But one person who has a healthy, strong cow and it is of middle age and he will not use it for any work, it's almost impossible. And there is only one way, and that is if someone will worshipping is someone is worshipping cow and he will leave a cow or put a cow for this purpose, then he will not use the cow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caught them through their weakness. Qalul ana jitta bil haqq. They said, O Musa, now you have brought us the accurate description. Although they don't need this description, if they will get a cow and they slaughter it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not test them through all this procedure. But they ask questions and questions and questions, because they were not ready to slaughter a single cow. Fazabahuha. After that, they slaughtered the cow. Wama kadu yafalun. After they had nearly declined, they were not ready to slaughter a cow, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bound them so closely that they had to do this. Wa and is when. Wa is kataltum. And remember, when you killed nafsan a man, fadda ra'tum, and started disputing as to know who killed him. Wallahu mukhrijun. Allah made it known, ma kuntum taktumun, what you concealed. Fakulna dribuhu, so we said, strike the dead body with the piece of the slaughtered cow. Tazalika yuhyi Allahul mauta, that's how Allah brought the dead to life. Wa yurikum ayatihi, to show you his signs. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ, that you may understand. MashaAllah. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking them to remember that one of them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding them another incident, that when one of them was killed a man out of them, and after his death, after his murder, they started fighting, they started disputing that who was the killer. And for the clarification, for the judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them to slaughter a cow, and Allah asked them to touch the dead body with a piece of the cow. When they have done this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the dead body alive. And he told them the complete incident and he died again. Allah is saying, we have shown you all this so you may understand the reality of life after death. Ahadith have told us the whole incident. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that, as we have read before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them 12 different water streams. And every tribe has his own water source. So one boy who has an old uncle who was very wealthy, he wants to marry his daughter because he had only one daughter. But because he was not a good boy, he has bad habits. His uncle, brother of his father, was not ready to marry his daughter with him. So out of rage, that boy killed his uncle secretly and put his dead body into someone's house who belongs to an other tribe. He threw his body in an other tribe. So when Alhamdulillah the new day started and people found out the dead body, there started a quarrel. He claimed, the nephew claimed his uncle's murder and asked the chief of the tribe for justice. On the other hand, the people of the other tribe were saying that we didn't kill him. Why should we kill him? Even we don't know who put his dead body in our tribe. So first find out who killed him. So both chiefs of both tribes had discussions, but they couldn't able to make a decision. So they decided to get help from Musa alayhi salam, who was the head of the Bani Israel and their messenger of the time, and obviously their chief justice as well. So all people came to Musa alayhi salam all together and asked his help for this case. Musa alayhi salam prayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, guide me in this case. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, oh Musa, ask these people to slaughter a cow. They said, Musa, we are asking you to help us to do justice with this man who has been killed, and you are asking us to slaughter a cow. Are you making fun of us? Musa alayhi salam replied, I seek Allah's refuge, Allah's protection from this ignorant action that I will do fun, I will make fun of you in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm not lying, I'm telling you a truth. They said, oh Musa, there are so many cows. What type of cow we should slaughter? Please request Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tell us something special, some sign. Musa alayhi salam prayed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them to slaughter a cow of middle age. Any cow, as I have told you, this is the same criteria which we have followed on the time of Eid Zuha. So any cow which is middle-aged could be slaughtered. But they raised another question and asked, oh Musa, please ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what should be the color of the cow? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied them, it should be brown, dark brown, beautiful color. The one who will look at it, feel pleasant. Okay. Now they said, oh Musa, there are so many cows who are look alike. How could we choose one? Please ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to tell us some exact description. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caught them by telling them a distinguished cow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them, slaughter a cow which had never done some work. She had never plowed the fields and never watered the fields. And it should be a beautiful, healthy, strong cow. It should not have any blemish in its body. Now, this was difficult. And they said, Kalul ana jita bil haqq. This time, Musa, you have brought the right description. Actually, they secretly chose some cows and set them aside. They don't use them for work and give them respect for their worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told Musa alayhi salam in this manner that his people are still a victim of hypocrisy. They are suffering from this disease yet. Anyways, our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that there was a pious man in Bani Israel. He had a son who was a young boy, and he has a small calf of, cow, a small calf. It was a female cow, it was very young. He got sick and he felt that he could not survive. So he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, I am leaving my cow in the forest. When my son will be adult, please benefit him through this cow. So he released his cow, and after a couple of days he died. When his son, mashallah, was adult, he became young. He asked his mother, oh mother, how should I start my work? I don't have a penny to spend. Then how should I do something for my livelihood? His mother replied, oh my son, your father had left a calf in the forest. Now it must be a young cow. Brought it back. It was strong and dark brown cow. So boy went to the forest and found the cow and took him back. But he was very upset. He asked his mother that, oh mother, now this cow is useless for me. I can't use this cow to plow my fields and not to use it to fetch water from the well to water the fields. So how could I take benefit from it? His mother replied him, your father prayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this cow beneficial for you. Have trust, my son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make some way. So one day, after this incident of the boy that who took the cow from the forest, they met this incident of murder, and they came to Musa alayhi salam, and Musa alayhi salam asked them to slaughter a cow which had never done a work, which had never plow a field, which had never water a field, and it should be of brown color and it should be healthy. All these conditions were in that cow of that boy. So people came to him and asked him to sell his cow to them, and they gave him a big amount for that cow. In this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless that boy. And on the other hand, there are different mashallah moral lessons in this part. The first one is hypocrisy, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed that those people still had a hypocrisy inside their hearts, and therefore they were not able to even slaughter a single cow on the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Musa alayhi salam had understood their condition, their level of iman. On the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that if we will ask help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we trust him, he make things easy for us. So a pious man at the time of his death trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leave his son and his cow in Allah's hand. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a great benefit out of that cow for his son. So Allah works in mysterious ways, mashallah. And there is another thing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them to touch the dead body with the part of the slaughtered cow. They took a piece of meat and just touch it, and the body got alive. He sat down. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam described it in hadith that when they touched the dead body with the piece of meat, he sat down and he told them about the whole incident, and then he lie down and died again. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showed them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do anything, and it is a open proof of life after death. The Allah who can make alive a dead man on the face of the earth, he can make us alive after our death on the day of the judgment. So all these messages are hidden in these verses, mashallah. And because of this incident, this surah got the name of Baqara, means the cow. And there is another lesson, that the people who used to make excuses and not obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order, actually they have an effect of hypocrisy in them. So they should pay attention on their disease. All these messages are hidden in these verses, mashallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with iman and ikhlas. Ameen summa ameen. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.